Now the scene shifts to the deceptively placid location of the famous Broadmoor Resort Hotel in Colorado Springs for the next chapter of the story, the 1965 World Figure Skating Championships. We're 6,000 feet above sea level here in the Rocky Mountains. Of all the great skaters gathered in this arena, a certain few will capture the hearts of the crowd. What makes the story exciting is this question: who will it be? From Colorado Springs, Colorado, it's the most significant international winter sports event of 1965, the World Figure Skating Championships. Another ABC Sports exclusive, brought to you by Hunt's new catsups in flavors, hickory flavor catsup and pizza flavor catsup, both great on everything you use catsup on. And by Johnson Wax, creators of Pledge, for wax beauty instantly as you dust. Will be the new champion. Will it be graceful 16-year-old Peggy Fleming, United States title holder from Pasadena, California? She faces an uphill battle because she stood only fourth at the end of the compulsory figure. Or will it be the young power skater from Canada, Petra Burka, Olympic bronze medalist, perhaps the best lady free skater in the world, and surprisingly, the leader at the end of the school figures by a very narrow margin? Or will it be the pretty Austrian girl who came here as the pre-championship favorite, Olympic silver medalist Regina Heitzer? Well, I'm Jim McKay, and giving us the benefit of his knowledge and his background once again tonight, he's going to be one of the greatest figure skaters of all time. As a matter of fact, the first person ever to win a gold medal for the United States in this sport, Dick Button. Dick, what is the special, particular significance of this year's World Championship?
Well, I think the significance is that there, for the first time, there is... In a very long time, there is no defending world champion. There are several bronze, silver, and gold medalists from the Olympic Games last winter who will be trying for their first world title, but nobody is defending, and therefore it's wide open.
How about the women's division specifically that we're watching right now?
Well, I think there we're going to see a very exciting competition. That was a beautiful performance that Regina Heitzer just gave, but I think that the favorite is going to be Petra Burka from Canada, the bronze medalist at the last Winter Olympic Games, because she's leading in the school figures, and she's a very strong and consistent skater.
All right, we'll know very soon. Right now, the next scheduled skater is our American champion, Peggy Fleming. And just before she skates, here's the way the girls stand at this moment. Of those who have skated, Regina Heitzer has just taken the lead. She has fine marks, averaging about 5.7. In second place, Mia Fukuhara of Japan, then Jones of Canada, Seifert of Germany, Schmidt of Austria, and Kinoy of the United States is Peggy Fleming, the United States champion for the past 2 years. She was sixth in the Olympic Games a year ago. She stood fourth at the end of the compulsory figures here, remember, so she really has to go in a bright red skating dress.
I think, Jim, that Peggy Fleming's style is one of the most beautiful in this competition, and she's got great athletic ability along with it. Watch this, a double flip jump. Now watch the arm. And here comes a very difficult jump for a girl, a double axel, 2.5 revolutions. Here it is. And that was a beauty of a jump. That was wonderful. Her problem here tonight is to do much better than she did in the North American Championship a few weeks ago when she fell down, unfortunately, several times.
So far, would you say she is as good or better than she was at Lake Placid in the Nationals?
I'd say so far she's just as good, but there's a very serious problem here, and that is the altitude. And it's a very strenuous program, 4 minutes, for a slim and slender girl like Peggy Fleming. Here comes a difficult jump, a double lutz, 2 revolutions, and again, watch the hand. But that was a nice one.
Now let's watch and listen to the beauty, the grandeur, and the loneliness of championship figure skating.
That position.
thousands of eyes here, millions with you at home, on one slim 16-year-old girl.
Watch this spread eagle now and look at her back, the straightness with which that's done.
Become the favorite here by taking the lead in the school figures, remember, little Petra Burka of Canada.
Here comes an interesting combination of jumps. First of all, a split jump. There it is. And now a double split jump. There it is. Coming now into the end of her program. Double toe loop jump. Here's an axle, a delayed axle. That was a beauty. Double salto, and she's now going into our final combination. A flying sit spin. Now watch her pull this last spin on the leg, and watch the hands go over the head in a very fast track. A beautiful performance by Peggy Fleming.
And listen to this.
Overcame the bad performance that she put on in the North American Championship 2 weeks ago with a beautiful one tonight.
This is certainly the same champion that we saw in the United States Championship at Lake Placid. They won't give up on the applause.
I think what stands out about her skating is the beautiful style with which she does all of those difficult jumps and spins.
And now stand by for the mark for little Peggy Fleming of California. And here they are. They are beautiful.
Oh, that's a
5'8".
They're all 5'8". They're all the
Not time. Quite, Dick. 5'8", 5'8", 5'8", then a 5'9". Here it is from the French judge. 5'8", 5'8", 5'8", another 5'9". From the American judge right here. And then a 5'8" from the Russian judge to round them out. Beautiful mark for Peggy Fleming. We'll be back in just a minute then with more of ABC's exclusive coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships in Colorado.
Petra Burka of the Canadian Figure Skating.
Here's the way they stand as Petra Burka is going to come on the ice. Regina Heitzer's in first place, Peggy Fleming second, and now Christine Hagler has dropped down to third.